Hey, everybody, and welcome back to Simian Jimmy's Treehouse, a very special episode of Survivor Branch Steel Simulator. We've done these many times before, and we're doing it again, this time with three tribes. I am the leader of tribe number three, Simian Jimmy, joined as always by the one and only Eggy, Eggman Rodriguez.
What is up, fellow survivors? Oh my goodness, I've been surviving my whole entire life. In fact, there's nothing else I've ever accomplished. So I'm very excited to be a part of this challenge today. I think we're taking it all the way to the bank.
And making his debut on the Treehouse Brant Steels, we have LowRes Wonderbread.
Such an honor to be part of the historic lore of the Treehouse Brant Steels and have my own tribe and be a player, even if it came at the expense of a beautiful woman of color from Flavor of Love Season 2.
Yeah, you can join this deep, rich lore where I think my cat won a season 4 years ago. I'm sure we've had Amazing. Just any random people win. But who will win today? Let's take a look at who we all chose to be on our tribe, starting with Eggy and the Eggy tribe. Eggy, would you like to describe who this first man is? He's an interesting-looking fellow.
Yes, I believe that's incel coworker.
I was talking about the one to the left of him, actually.
So that's what my coworkers would call incel co. Yes, Mr. Eggy Rodriguez, okay. An accomplished man who's never had a YouTube account for the record. Because if he did, then he would be violating TOS with his new account that he just remembered he logged into after 15 years of inactivity. But I really see a bright future ahead in being able to create content for that gentleman there. I think he's really got what it takes to drink a 12-pack of beer on camera.
Quality content. So contestant number one is Eggy Rodriguez. Next to him is somebody named Incel Coworker. Now, he seems to be an overweight, bald, black elderly man standing next to a smiling egg creature. Now, is this some sort of AI-created abomination to make your coworker?
Well, as a matter of fact, it absolutely is. I ran it without anybody else in the room a couple of times, and it just, I don't know, it's something about, maybe it's my own perspective of being an overweight man who spends all his time alone, but I'm like, oh, he doesn't look quite as depressed as I was trying to put forward. Now, not to say, because there's a theoretical chance that he could eventually watch this video, very slim, I think. Because I know some people from my work, I believe, are subscribed to this channel. But anyways.
Why did you choose this incel coworker to be on your tribe? Tell us a little bit about him, because we don't think we have talked about him on the show.
No, because I don't tend to talk too much about my workplace, but between me and Monkey, I've talked about this gentleman a few times. He's just he's a interesting guy. Yes, he's an older African-American man. A little bit on the heavier set side. In fact, you might say morbidly obese. And he basically has had nobody in his life for possibly decades, it seems like. He's only told me one story about how he did have his brother from another. They were friends back. They lived out in Los Angeles together. But he got his Asian wife or whatever, and then he... He said, in the words of my incel coworker, most of them Asians don't like us black people. Once he got his Asian wife, he felt like it was a little bit of an awkward situation. And I guess they kind of fit apart. And he often laments the fact that he never was able to find his own Asian wife because he was very fond of Asian women. But now he just spends all of his time. He says that he doesn't really like Netflix, but he'll just like turn it on. And basically, the only thing he ever eats is fast food. He doesn't know how to cook at all. He never learned. He just only eats fast food for every meal. And so he basically just sits alone in a house he rents with other 50-year-old men and just eats McDonald's alone in his room with Netflix playing. He doesn't really pay attention to it. He just sits and waits to go back to work. He often will sit at work for possibly hours unpaid just to conversate with whoever he's able to talk to at work, because he has nobody else to talk to in his life, it seems like. So, you know, he's
dream life.
He's a very relatable person, and I felt like, you know, he's really got the resilience and the tenacity and the strength mentally to be a great survivor.
LowRes, I think this is the type of character we're missing out on with real Survivor. They don't really cast incel, old, obese black men like they used to.
Well, you can't have a person of color who hasn't attended an Ivy League college on reality TV these days. So that would be a big no-no. I just think he's very well equipped for this survival game wearing those pajamas, or it looks like pajamas. Maybe it's a factory outfit.
It's hard to tell what he's wearing.
I think he's got a box of Chinese food. That's kind of an advantage over all the others.
Yeah, why does he get food? speaking of, just,
it's a descriptive situation. Food may be pending. It might just be illustrated and not real.
Well, I think if we're basing it off these photos, our next contestant also has an advantage. He has some sort of a beverage with him. Who is this? Onlai Ooze Me Blade? Is that how you pronounce it?
Speaking of other people in my life who are great inspirational figures, this is extremely successful, lifelong streamer, Only Use Me Blade, professional Call of Duty player. He was really the creme de la creme like 10 years ago. Now, I think most recently, after his girlfriend left him and he was complicit in the death of one of his fans during a live stream, he's now sleeping in one of his viewers' mother's houses where he gets drunk often for money. He recently streamed himself taking Ubers to a casino where I think last night he lost all his money, but he did win like a week or two ago.
So living the life, really.
Yeah, you know, he's doesn't have any teeth anymore. He's had holes in his legs for a long time from his untreated diabetes, but they haven't been there lately, so he's back to drinking and everyone's having a good time.
Is he still
like he's
using his blade?
Survivor.
Yeah, his whole life is Survivor.
That's right. That's
but
why
he doesn't use his blade on Call of Duty anymore.
He actually, I don't think he played Call of Duty for a long time. He has been playing it again since he's been living in this random woman's house.
Well, that's good.
So he's getting back to his roots, and he's still got it. I watched and he's still just doing the thing with the blade. I saw him, he killed like five dudes with the knife and didn't die. I was like, this guy's like 40 years old.
Yeah, still impressive.
That's right.
All right, next we have, I think he might have been departed from this world recently, but we have a bearded dragon named Puff Saunders. Eggy, who is this?
One of the greatest survivors I know. I mean,
I don't think he survived. I think he's gone.
The latest information I have is that he could survive in the Wyoming winter.
No, he fucking can't.
Up to 11 days, okay? No. I saw the Facebook post said up to 11 days. So I'm sure he's, I guess I can't be sure of anything because I'm not there. But
yeah, so this is King Cobra JFS, our favorite YouTuber. He had a pet bearded dragon who he loved more than anything. And he recently took it outside in the middle of winter, and it ran away from him and is now probably dead. I mean, it's been a long time. He's fucking dead. So rest in peace, Puff. This is a bit of a Puff piece. Any final thoughts on Puff before we move on to the real hero of your tribe?
No, you know, I'm sure he smells good. He's obviously a badass. He's got a pipe in his mouth and his delicious Bush Light. Peach flavor, by the way. A real hero and a real survivor, if you ask me.
Ain't nothing to puff with. That's right. Okay. Who is the next contestant? If you did not listen to the episode Eggy's Jury Duty, go pause this and listen to that real quick so you can learn all about Tyrone Jackson, Eggy.
That's right. Tyrone Jackson, he was a man who fate connected me with. I was a juror in his trial of criminal sexual conduct, where unfortunately, you know, it was another sister, but she wasn't, her third eye wasn't opened. He really tried to open her third eye, but she alleged she was trying to open some other holes too without consent. But after some real justice delivered by me personally, he was found not guilty. So he was the original man. He said he's the original Earth Man, in that, he's prove that white people were created by Yakub, and that the reason why him as a black earth man is the same color as dirt is because he's created from the earth. He's a natural man. very intelligent. You know, he would always talk about me overstanding his mental. And his mental was so overstood, I said, this is a real survivor against this crooked justice system, against these crooked women that can't understand when it's time to get woke. They're trying to get a man up in the pokey and get poked. So,
and I do think he has the ultimate advantage because we know for a fact he can convince a jury of his peers to vote on his behalf. Mm-hmm. As a black man, he has a physical advantage over all these whiteys that I'm seeing. And I can't overstand his mental. He does have, you know, intelligence beyond my capabilities. So he's a triple threat, Tyrone Jackson. I'm looking out for him in this game. But
that's a merge boot.
Oh, you think so? He's going to get 13th place.
I think he's too much of a threat. Yeah, yes, I think so. Him and incel coworker having that genetic advantage, you know, it's going to be too much for
people. You know, this was as I was kind of coming down to who I was thinking of. I was like, you know, and these guys, it seems to me I don't watch as much reality television as you gentlemen, but I understand that the race war aspect has been very prevalent in recent reality show seasons, from my understanding.
Definitely. So.
I think that we might see that component come into play, possibly.
Well, thankfully, we don't have the 50% BIPOC requirement, so they're going to have to be a little squatted, too, it looks like. I don't know if there's too many other, you know, big black men to play with.
That's true, yeah.
Last but not least, in terms of monetary value on Eggy's Tribe, we have a YouTuber named Vegas Matt.
Now, once again, a real survivor. He can go to that particular Soy Jack thumbnail there. That was a video where he lost like $140,000 in like a 1 hour slot machine session. So I know that he can really take a beating and still keep pushing. So when I thought about that, I said, you know, we need to recruit him. Absolutely.
And I did just watch, he was on a podcast, Vegas Matt, and he talked about where his money comes from. And I guess he owns a lot of property in some third world island shitholes. So, you know, that's the game. Go buy up like hotels and shit that are cheap as fuck and then just rake in money for free and waste it on YouTube videos at the casino.
I do want to say one thing, though, about that is that he did admit in some... I think this was the first podcast he did. He said that he actually made a lot of money off of multi-level marketing.
Yeah, they talked about that a lot, too, on the podcast. Yeah. He defended it. No, he defended it. He's like, listen, it's a reverse funnel system. You know, he went through the whole shebang, and he convinced me. I was like, you know what, Amway, they're probably not crooks at all. They're probably a bunch of heroes. I mean, they're called American Way. You can't be a shitty company. Anyway, LowRes, enough about Eggy's Tribe, because they're all going to be pre-merge, okay? We're talking about the LowRes Tribe today. And hopefully you can't see a spoiler on who's on mine.
I was going to say, you stole my co-host for your tribe.
They can't see it again. Don't spoil.
Wow. Ultimate betrayal. Okay, so I wanted to go more team TV, you know, very celebrity-based and driven. I wanted an A-list mainstream cast of players from my tribe here. Now, I will say, I was not aware that we were going to be the team captains, the Russell Swan, Jonathan Penner, Michael Scoopin of the season here. So I'm feeling a little caught off guard by my lady something from season two of Flavor of Love not being in there. But that's all right. I think she was going to weigh my tribe down.
These I think players it fits that you and Vegas Matt are kind of making the same face and you're both way off at the end there.
Wow. Amazing. Final two? I don't know.
It could
be. We'll see what happens. So we got Ben Shapiro here. Now, Ben Shapiro is very revved up these days. I don't know if you've seen his Twitter feed, but he is just on a rage. He's going nuts. So I think
I'm guessing he's pro Hamas.
Flame out quick. Oh, he loves Hamas. He can't get enough Hamas. They were around his Thanksgiving dinner table all this week. So Ben, he's either going to go the distance or he's going to flame out fast, I think. We got Jeff Varner, who's on, was it this show?
Oh, yeah. We had him on to review What is a Woman not too long ago because he's famous for outing a trans person. So we thought he might be a gender specialist.
Yes. And Jeff has been the subject of controversy once again this week because a former Survivor winner treated him like a human being.
That's true.
So Jeff, he's going to be a great member of my tribe. But again, thinking with good TV in mind, we had to put in somebody who would conflict with Jeff a little bit. And here we have Jeffrey Marsh, the TikTok Vine influencer, the 50-year-old trans, they, them, he, her, she, he. He's in there. They're in there. I think.
Does this person have any like famous moments? Because I don't really recognize Jeffrey Marsh.
Not in particular. I remember Jeffrey Marsh mainly from my Tumblr days, seeing a lot of Vines reblogged on there. But they've come up yet again, complaining about aging and looking too masculine or something. I don't know. I've seen Jeffrey Marsh come up on Twitter, so I feel like okay, the time is ripe for a Survivor appearance. Now, I was thinking Mr. Beast, because Mr. Beast, I feel like that's a slam dunk victory. But I decided to go with somebody a little more swept under the rug, Jeremy Fragrance, because I do love a good cologne or fragrance. So he's in there.
Yeah, this is another character I'm not familiar with. Could you give me a little 101 on Jeremy?
Jeremy is a Instagram influencer who loves to recommend colognes and perfumes, and I'm very interested in the whole fragrance space, having befriended Jack the Perfume Nationalist, done his show a couple of times. He's a big Survivor fan as well. Jeremy is kind of like the antithesis of Jack, and I believe he actually played Celebrity Big Brother in Germany and then quit after 3 days. He has some experience here. We got the oldest man alive, Joe Biden. I think Joe Biden is fit to be the Rudy Bosch of the season for Survivor fans. I think he has a very good shot of going the distance. And last but not least, you have yours truly, LowRes Wonderbread. I'm going to say third boot for me.
Yeah, forced into the game against his will, you know. It's not looking too good for LowRes, but with Joe Biden might be able to carry your team to immunity every episode, so you might make it to merge without even trying.
Yeah, we'll see. That expression I'm making is me finding out I'm a cast member in this Survivor game. So.
That's Mike Boogie when he's forced into BB14 as a player.
yeah.
And finally, we have the Simian tribe. I wanted to get some familiar faces that we all know and love, starting with Eggy's best friend, Florian Himsel. There's a deep blood feud between these two men. It's very much one-sided. And if Eggy and Florian end up on the same tribe, I'm excited to see if anybody gets killed in a violent way. Any thoughts on Florian, Eggy?
Hey, you know what? May the best intellectual who is socially conscious of all political issues affecting us these days win.
May the best descendant of Austrian men win.
Some of us are only descended philosophically in an Austrian.
I will say that sly, knowing smirk on Florian's face makes me think he's going to be a very cunning master strategist here. I'm going to say final. Now, you know, he's probably not final four. I could see final eight for Florian.
Well, somebody write down these predictions because we'll have to get back to them eventually. Next, we have a man who, if you've watched our collab episodes with movies, a podcast about the act of cinema, or really if you just know who LowRes is at all, you've probably seen this man. It's his co-host, Hans Muslim Anderson, the man who I claim to be my favorite podcaster of my favorite podcast, B-Bang. So I could not do this without Hans. Do you have any thoughts on Hans, Eggy?
Hey, I don't know too much about him outside of the broadcasting space, but he really does seem like a stand-up, top-notch guy. Probably my favorite person of European descent involved so far today.
European? Wait, where does he live?
I mean, Hans, I mean, I don't really know, but I know he's, Hans is a European name, right?
Yeah.
It certainly is. Yeah, he's very mysterious with his background. He's like Count Dracula.
Is he just trying to hide what's actually in his house? He doesn't want us to see.
I don't think he wants people digging into his historic lineage and why his father fled to South America.
Oh yeah, we probably don't want to touch that one here. So I guess we'll move on to everybody's favorite Mario, Rich Alvarez. We all just reviewed the Rich Alvarez movie, Super Mario Brothers, the movie, and we all loved it and said it was Kino. You know, he's been a longtime supporter of me. He has no personal gripes with me, so I thought he would fit on my tribe. Then, of course, we have me. Then after that, the man who has perhaps made the best YouTuber movie of all time, The Kino Corner.
He's the only other person who looks distraught to be in this cast here. He looks like he's just been traumatized by something. So,
that's his Kevin Smith photo. I love using that for any excuse.
I think Kino is going to be an early boot here. I do want to say Rich Alvarez is my prediction for first boot. He looks too, I'm happy to be here.
Yeah, I chose the fattest faced picture I could of Rich. And I could have had one of Hans with hair, but I decided to just take a screen cap from the podcast. Mm. And speaking of big fat faces, last but not least, we've got the whale. I could not remember the character's name, so he's still just the whale. LowRes, we've reviewed that together, didn't we? I think you were there.
Yes, we did. We did, yeah.
Great
and
film.
I think the consensus was it's good, I guess.
It's hilarious, was my consensus. If I have to do a winner pick out of these 18 contestants, Tyrone Jackson's pretty high, but I'm also rooting for the whale. Eggy, do you have any winner picks?
Well, I mean, the whale, he looks really determined. He's got some extra fat storage going on. You know, Rich, I got to say, and I'm going to have to counter signal first boot. I mean, this man, we see his survival on YouTube. I mean, he's still going live.
Barely.
After 15 years. I mean, you know, I've been doing this I felt like I was losing hope after like 5 years, you know, and like by the time I was on my seventh channel or whatever. But, you know, Rich has really been putting in that work. He's staying true to the game. I think Ben Shapiro talks a big game. I think he's probably going to be one of the first ones out. I think Joe Biden might even outlast him.
Joe Biden might just drop dead in the middle of the game.
I mean, he's a president at 100 years old. Nobody's done that before. I think he's really got that survival genetic. He's been on that adrenochrome. You know, he's got it going on.
LowRes, any last-minute predictions before we start the game?
I'm getting a vibe that my tribe is going to be very, like, gone in the middle of the game, and your tribe is going to probably take a lot of hits early on. You'll get one or two players in the end game, and the winner will be on Eggy's tribe. That's my feeling.
Okay. Well, let's see who's correct. Proceed to the twist. Each tribe selects a leader based on first impressions. The Eggy tribe selects Puff, the bearded dragon, as their leader. Wow, LowRes tribe selects Biden. I am considering voter fraud here. Do we think he actually got the majority of votes?
We got to tally those machines up.
Yeah, I think there's some bullshit. And Simian tribe has selected Florian. So, you know, not the first time an Austrian man became leader and made everything better for everybody. So I'm looking forward to that. We also have to choose. Okay, each leader has to choose the weakest player. I forgot about this twist. So Puff selects incel coworker as the weakest. Do we think there's some sort of bias here, Eggy?
I can't say. I mean, I've never met a prejudiced bearded dragon before. I think they like everybody who smells good. So maybe the fast food aroma is not on the sensory positives.
Biden selects Jeremy as the weakest. Would you concur, LowRes? Is Jeremy the weakest of that tribe?
I think there's enough evidence to point in the direction of both quitting Celebrity Big Brother and then putting up a video of himself being bullied by a bunch of 14 and 15-year-olds laughing at him. So I think there might be something to that.
Huh. Wow. And Florian selects the whale as the weakest, which I think there might be some bias here. I think the two fattest contestants have been thrown out early on. The weakest players are airlifted to the camp while everybody else has to make the multiple mile trek. And they have a choice. They can either get a clue to the hidden immunity idol or they can get an extra bag of rice for the tribe. Let's see what everybody chose. Incel coworker, he's a team player. He picks the bag of rice. Jeremy, not so much, takes the clue. And I can't scroll down anymore. Give me 1 second to fix the screen. And the whale also takes the clue. So incel coworker, the only team player.
Shocking that the whale did not opt for the food.
Yeah. Yeah. Does he think he can eat the clue maybe and he didn't want to share the rice? He's just going to eat the parchment. Mm. There are no alliances and nobody has found the Eggy idol. LowRes tribe, same deal. Simian tribe, same deal. No alliances, no idols. What's going on? This is not the Survivor I know. All right. Immunity challenge number one. LowRes tribe wins. They also get a fire making kit. Oh, God. Who predicted that my tribe's going to go down in flames? Because they were right.
Rich Alvarez. Bye-bye. See you later, pal.
Eggy tribe wins the other immunity, which means, Simian tribe's going to be at tribal council tonight. Let's see what's going on. The Eggy tribe, nobody has found the idol, but Vegas Matt is impressing the team. What do you think he's doing, Eggy?
Well, I would have to imagine he's devised some sort of way to play a slot machine with sand and rocks, and everybody's liking and subscribing. That's just his natural charisma. That's why he's able to make so much money selling Amway lotion or whatever he sold.
Now, when
he's got that natural gist.
When he loses 10 grand in a machine, he does call it a Sando. So, you know, Sando, is there anything here that we can work with, Eggy? What does Sando mean? Shit sandwich?
That's correct, yeah.
Okay.
And if it ain't a Grando, it's a Sando. So he's got to go all the way.
On the LowRes tribe, Ben Shapiro is impressing the rest of the team, and Ben and LowRes, they're bonding strongly. So what do you think you're bonding over?
Me joining the tribe, so to speak. Not this tribe. The tribe.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Okay, well, LowRes has formed the first alliance of the game with Ben Shapiro. Meanwhile, what's going on with the Simian tribe? Right before tribal council, the whale, using his clue that he got, finds the hidden immunity idol. And, yeah, good job. Meanwhile, Rich Alfred and Symbian Jimmy have a minor disagreement. Could it be about perhaps sharing some behind-the-scenes relationship info in a YouTube video? It could be really anything.
I can see it.
The whale is impressing the rest of the team, and Jimmy works hard at camp and becomes tired. So far, that's the least realistic thing I've seen in this game. Definitely not going to be working hard, but let's see what's going on at Tribal Council. Uh-oh.
Let's play it out.
Is the whale going to use his idol? Let's find out. Nobody stands. Okay, if the whale gets voted out, he's going home with an idol in his pocket. First vote, Rich Alvarez. LowRes, what the fuck? How did you know? Second vote, Rich Alvarez. Third vote, Hans.
Uh-oh.
Fourth vote, Hans. It's a tie, 2-2. Third vote, Hans. Uh-oh. That's not good. Jesus, no, Hans. No.
Wow.
No.
Oh, man. I was this close to having it on. On point. Damn. Sorry, Hans.
That would have been nice if Rich left and Hans got to stay. I don't know if I even need to elaborate on that. But, I mean, first, LowRes doesn't want Hans on his tribe. He rejects his own dear co-host. I'm gracious enough to let him on, and then we vote his ass out anyway. Rest in peace, Hans. I don't know how he's going to recover from this one. Wow. It was led by Florian, it looks like, but I guess I joined in. The whale and Hans were teamed up against Rich, it looks like. All right, Simian tribe, we're not looking too good.
Well, it's a two-part premiere, right? So there's still a chance Rich leaves in the first episode here.
I hope so. Yeah, you are correct. We're still in episode one. Still no idol found on the LowRes tribe. Nothing happens on the Simian tribe. And, Simian tribe wins immunity, thank God. And LowRes wins again, which means Eggy will be losing a member today. And it won't be Rich Alvarez, unfortunately. Blade, only use me, Blade, as a major meltdown. Eggy, can you even conceive of this? Could this possibly happen?
Well, you know, lately, I will say this. Actually, I think I misspoke earlier saying that he broke up with his girlfriend because I believe he did. From my understanding, I didn't watch it, but I guess he was, like, blackout drunk playing Call of Duty last night, just screaming the N-word, into voice chat for hours, which allegedly was deleted by his girlfriend in order to save his channel from being destroyed. So, it's possible, but I've never seen it. I think he's really on top of it, except for that time that he was at that guy's house and urinated all over the floor or whatever. That wasn't very good.
But, so he might be yelling the N-word at Tyrone and incel coworker.
I would say that if he wasn't, I wouldn't believe that he would not be doing that at all times.
Okay. Tyrone and Vegas Matt have a minor disagreement. Any clue what this might be about?
Well, I'm going to guess that Tyrone is probably talking to Vegas Matt like, yo, man, you got to open your third eye, man. This gambling, you're gambling with your life and your soul, but you need to be whole because inside this where is the real gold. You don't need a jackpot. No, you just need to not lack thought. And Vegas Matt's over there like, No. But man. And then, yeah, it's probably something like that.
Okay. Meanwhile, we have an Eggy alliance. Eggy, incel coworker, Puff, and Vegas Matt. They're teaming up against Tyrone and Blade. I'm liking Eggy's chances at this tribal council. LowRes and Biden have a minor disagreement. LowRes, can you think of anything you disagree with Joe Biden about?
Oh, geez. There's such a big list there. I don't want to get political, though. I mean, this is shaping up to be quite a political tribe. Me and Ben aligned, Biden and I disagreeing. I mean, this is playing out just like real life.
Do you think it was a non-political issue? Maybe he wanted a turn to smell the children, like the jungle children?
It's possible Biden could be inappropriately touching the people, pulling a Dan Spilo.
He's going to get
on the island.
Final five, they're going to pull him from the game so that you can clinch the victory.
Yep.
Jeremy joins the Ben and LowRes alliance.
Nice. I'm very happy about that.
Meanwhile, Florian and Kino have a minor disagreement, probably about some fucking shitty movie. And Rich has a major meltdown. I'm not going to say divorce, but, you know, probably related. It's time for the Eggy Tribal Council. Nobody plays an idol. And Tyrone gets one vote. Blade gets one vote. Blade. Tyrone, it's 2-2. Blade. And it's a tie. 3-3. The Eggy Alliance just fucking split their vote. And Tyrone and Blade voted for each other. So let's vote again. Blade. Blade. And Blade, yep, as all straight on Blade this time.
They didn't want to go to rocks.
Smart thinking. You know, they flushed a potential idol with the split vote, and nothing happened, so Blade went home. Eggy, do you have any thoughts on Blade having his big meltdown and then getting voted out?
Well, it does seem to be kind of a recurring theme of his entire life for as long as I've been familiar with his content, which is about 5 years. So, yeah, it tracks, yeah.
All right. LowRes Tribe is currently in the lead. We don't need to see these votes. We will go on to episode 2 with the Eggy Alliance staying strong, the Ben Shapiro Alliance staying strong, and still no alliances on the Simian Tribe for some reason. The Eggy Tribe wins immunity and LowRes, which means Rich Alvarez, your time might be coming. Let's find out. Yeah, LowRes, you're doing good. Your tribe's just killing it in every challenge.
Yeah, this is a very well-rounded group of players. I'm very happy about our odds now going into the second half of the game.
Well, your main alliance member, Ben, has had a major meltdown, probably an uncommon occurrence on his show.
Well, that's part of the course when you're working with Ben Shapiro here. I think he's probably not happy about the fact that they are dragging Ben Joe Biden a little deeper into the game.
He wanted to throw the challenge.
Political disagreement. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. He wanted to pull in Ozzy and get rid of Billy Garcia there, but it ain't happening.
Yeah, you're dragging Joe to the end because you know his final two speech is going to be dog shit. Meanwhile, Varner and Jeremy find something in common. I guess they're both gay men, I assume, just by how they look.
Jeremy's a good Christian man who
loves not gay.
Women, but he... Well, he did say he went to Hollywood and some gay men tried to do things to him and he didn't like it.
So that's probably not the thing he finds in common with Varner then. Probably something else. Rich Alvarez and Kino Corner, they bond slightly.
Filmmaker bond, of course.
I guess they both probably liked the new Mario cartoon movie. And Kino also bonds with the whale.
No. Uh-oh.
Could it be a Simian tribe alliance that seems to have everybody except for Simian Jimmy in it, which is a little concerning going into tribal council? Oh, God. How did Rich Alvarez win over the loyalty of Kino Corner, Whale, and Florian without me? Rich is injured, but gets treated and can stay in the game. How about fuck you? My one last chance to stay in the game is Rich Alvarez breaking his damn leg, and they treat it. Dr. Joe, how about fuck off? Well, let's just go to my funeral. I'm not. Is the whale going to use his idol to save me? Could it be?
I don't think so.
What? First vote is Rich. That's got to be from me, I have to assume. I mean, if there's another Rich, I'm going to be shocked. And Jimmy, okay.
No.
I noticed a pattern. Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, no more me. Good thing nobody had me as their winner pick, huh?
Rich Alvarez is really shaping up to be the villain of the season here.
If anything, I'm the villain, and he just, vanquished the dragon. I think this is Rich's season to win. Slayer. Yeah, he's the true Dragon Slayer now.
I don't think so. I think we're going to see Rich, since he's not the first boot, there's some weird vibe to him. He's either going to, I don't think he's going to win. I think he's going to get medevaced or quit.
He does have that injury now, so hopefully he'll injure it even more. But yes. Simian Tribe's down to their best four players, and we proceed. Not much happening on the tribes. At the challenge, Eggy Tribe wins a reward, not even immunity, just an reward. Who cares? Waste of time. But Eggy Tribe then wins immunity anyway. Simian Tribe wins immunity, which means LowRes, you're finally going to Tribal Council.
Yep. All right, let's see what happens here. Damn, Tyrone needed that.
Yep, Tyrone finds the Eggy Tribe hidden idol, and he's also impressing the rest of the team. So big episode for Tyrone. And Puff chooses to leave the Eggy Tribe alliance. Eggy, why is Puff being removed?
Well, he left. He jumped off the shoulder of the alliance, and he's running off into the forest of isolation and liberty and freedom. He's atomized. I think maybe he was so impressed by Tyrone. He's like, "Oh, listen, we're not allied with Tyrone. I think he's a smart guy. He might be looking to reform. New alliance coming up."
Now, when Puff ran away from the alliance, did you call your family to help look for him? Did you call, pet emergency services in Casper, Wyoming? Or did you kind of just forget about it?
Yeah, to be honest, I mean, we just won a chicken and a rooster from this challenge we did. I think it's time for a dank chicken and food hack on the campfire. I'll let the rest of the alliance know that he left in about 2 days if I feel like there's any reason to be concerned.
Yeah, when your YouTube ban wears off and you can come back. LowRes finds the LowRes tribe hidden idol right before tribal council.
Wow, everything is coming up LowRes.
Yeah, so Hans leaves first. You know, it could not be going better for LowRes.
Yeah, he's a mutineer.
Ben and Jeremy have a major fight. Does Jeremy, is he pro-Israel?
I would have to assume Jeremy Fragrance is pro-Israel. He's definitely in that sphere of things. I would think that this fight is probably over something very superficial here.
Most likely.
It seems like he's not along with Biden either.
Yeah, he picks a fight with Joe Biden as well. So he's just in a bad mood today, just fighting anybody he runs into. And he leaves the alliance. The fuck?
No. I think he wants to go. This is around the time he quit Celebrity Big Brother, so he's probably not dealing well with everybody's nasty sense. You know, everybody's sweating. It's campfire. He wants to go home. I think he's done.
So if he's the only one who smells good, is Joe Biden just sitting there sniffing him all fucking day? That's his favorite thing, is to sniff people?
I think so. He probably thinks he's the hidden immunity idol.
Okay, well, let's see. It's time to vote somebody out of the LowRes tribe. LowRes has the idol, but he does not play it, so he might be making a big mistake. Vote number one, Joe Biden. He's used to getting voted for. Jeremy Biden. We have two tie. Jeremy and Biden. Oh my God, LowRes, are you about to get rocked out of the game?
I'm going to feel like a fool if I didn't play my idol and I do get rocked out of the game. I don't think that's going to be the case here, though. I do think Jeremy is going to be toast. Joe, he's the weakest member. He's the oldest member. It's got to be one of these two guys.
Yeah, either way, your tribe will be stronger for it. Biden. It's all for Biden. So even though Jeremy had a bad day, picked fights with everybody, and quit his own alliance, everybody just voted out Biden anyway. Once again,
I think it's par of the course. You know, they always tend to get rid of the oldest person in the cast early on these days. It's not like the early days of reality TV where you could drag somebody to the final three or so. They were probably worried that Jeremy's holding the hidden immunity idol there in his photo. They wanted to flush it out. They don't know I got it. Mm-hmm. Makes sense.
Yep. And looks like you changed your vote in the revote, LowRes. So really, you mastermind this whole thing.
Yes.
Okay, let's keep going. We're down to five people in Eggy tribe, five in LowRes, four in the Simian tribe. I don't know if there's probably not any swaps coming up, is there?
I think there is.
Oh, okay. Well, all the tribes are meeting up in the same place. The tribe with the fewest remaining members will be dissolved. So the Simian tribe is dissolved, and they're randomly distributed between the Eggy tribe and the LowRes tribe. Who is hoping to get Rich Alvarez on their tribe?
Oh, not me. He's a bad, bad omen.
I think that him and my tribe are going to mesh very well.
So you want Florian and Rich on your tribe is what you're saying.
I think it's going to be good energy, good synergy if we can get Florian and Rich. But let's see what happens.
The Eggy tribe has added the whale and Rich Alvarez, it would appear.
But also Ben Shapiro, apparently.
How did Ben Shapiro wind
up? It looks like everybody's getting mixed up a little bit. So it's not really dissolving. It's more of just brand new tribes. But yeah, Eggy tribe is now Ben Shapiro, Eggy, incel coworker, Puff, Vegas Matt, Rich Alvarez, and the Whale. So really the original Eggy tribe has the advantage, numbers advantage here. The new LowRes tribe is Florian Himsel, Jeff Varner, Jeffrey Marsh, Jeremy Fragrance, LowRes, Kino, and Tyrone Jackson.
Uh-oh. Tyrone's got that idol. We could see a war break out.
But really, it looks like original LowRes has the advantage and original Eggy has the advantage. So just the Simian tribe is fucked. Whale still has his idol. And we have got all this nonsense on screen. Okay. LowRes has an idol. Tyrone has an idol. Okay. Let's move on. The Eggy tribe wins a reward. Who cares? LowRes tribe, though, wins immunity.
All right.
Meanwhile, Rich has a major meltdown and has a small fight with Puff, and it will have a lasting impact, of course. Mm-hmm. Meanwhile, Florian leaves some sort of alliance. Okay, yeah, this is just a bunch of bullshit. Rich works hard at camp and becomes tired.
The Whale joins the alliance of Eggy incel coworker in Vegas Matt. We're happy to have him.
Oh yeah, I think that is a rock solid. If anything, Vegas Matt might be squished out in favor of your loyalty to incel coworker in the Whale.
That's a 1,200-pound alliance right there.
Might be even more. Varner and Kino bond slightly.
That's questionable. I don't know. Maybe Varner finds him and his curls cute or something. I can't imagine what else they would have in common here.
They might dislike minors getting sex change operations. That might be a similarity between these two.
I like the idea that Varner's just talking about sex change operations.
On children, nonstop. I mean, if you look at his Twitter, it's basically all he brings up.
Yeah, no, you get a point there. Yeah. Yep.
Jeremy's having a major meltdown. What would he be melting down about?
I think he's just, you know, that bad mood is progressing the longer he stays in the game, but he doesn't know what he wants. I mean, clearly there's an alliance shaping up here of all the LowRes leftovers that does not include me. This is getting to be a dangerous situation for yours truly.
Yeah, that idol might have to carry you.
Yep.
Well, let's find out what's going to happen at the Eggy tribe. The Whale does not play his idol. First vote is for Puffers. He should not have ran away from that alliance. Ben Shapiro, he's the lone man on this new tribe. He doesn't belong.
Ben's an easy boot.
Ben. Puff. Puff. It's tied up. And Ben, by 4-3, he got swap screwed onto a tribe with none of his alliance, none of his former tribe, and they all just voted him out.
Many such cases.
Did he even stand a chance, LowRes?
Absolutely not. I think this was just a very easy way to go to avoid any sort of war breaking out. Ben, it was over for him as soon as we realized the rules that were set, that it was just a dissolve, were not in place, mm-hmm. and it was indeed a swap that occurred.
So swap screwed Ben. Okay. Mm-hmm. Is the merge coming up?
I don't think so.
Probably not.
I think we got a while.
Okay. More bullshit to go through. Okay. What we want to know is who won immunity. It was the Eggy tribe,
which means
LowRes might have to pull out that idol.
I better play that idol.
Rich and Vegas Matt bond strongly. Probably just talking about some YouTube shenanigans, you know, algorithms and whatnot. And right. Another alliance forms, it seems.
Rich is such a game player.
Yeah, he's really getting in with good with everybody. I don't see him getting voted out anytime soon. Varner and LowRes bond strongly. So what are you and Varner bonding about this time?
Probably the color purple, since it seems to be the common trait in both of our pictures here.
The I'm remake? The hoping... new one?
Yes.
Okay.
God, that new one looks really dreadful. I don't know. I'm probably just playing the social game here because I'm starting to feel a little outsidered, you know, with the three of them from my tribe.
Having an alliance without you. Yeah.
Sitting around the campfire, snuggling at night. Suddenly I'm not involved. It's very, very dodgy territory to be in, especially when Tyrone has an idol, too.
Meanwhile, Florian and Tyrone find something in common. I assume it's a respect for women.
I think it's their shared love of black power.
Marsh leaves some fucking alliance with Jeff. So maybe he's getting jealous that you were cozying up to Jeff there and he's, you know, dropping out. Meanwhile,
yeah, hopefully I can get in there.
It says LowRes is completely worn out, but is not giving up. So really, you had one conversation with Jeff Varner and you're spent. No more energy.
That's how I felt after that podcast.
I can't believe Florian didn't convince him he was wrong. That was a rough episode. Okay. LowRes tribe. Tyrone has an idol. LowRes has his idol. It's time to vote.
Tyrone's playing it.
Tyrone uses the idol on himself. And LowRes uses his idol on Jeff Varner. What?
Oh my Lord.
Whoa.
What kind of bonding did you guys do? And you did.
I mean, Jeff. He's probably telling me, yeah, you know, I know a casting associate on the next season of Survivor. I could probably get you on. Uh-huh. So I'm thinking, you know what? I'm going to be the Tyson here. I'm going to do the risky, dangerous move to see if it pays off later on. This is a wild tribal. Let's see
if I have to predict what is happening, I think LowRes and whoever he's with, they were voting for Tyrone. But once Tyrone played that idol, LowRes knows, uh-oh, my buddy Varner's probably got the second most amount of votes. So the question will be, who's got the third? And hopefully it's not you, LowRes.
God.
Read the votes. Tyrone does not count. 4 votes for Tyrone do not count. 5 votes for Tyrone. And Kino Corner. There's 2 votes for Kino Corner. LowRes wasted his idol on Jeff Varner.
That was a stupid ass move. But I'm glad to see Kino finally getting a bed and some food in his belly. He looked miserable the entire time out here.
And it would seem the 2 votes for Kino Corner were Florian and Tyrone teaming up to get him out. So I guess they did bond recently as well. So these little bonding things, they actually matter quite a bit. And two idols are now out of the game.
It's made all the difference. Now, I believe the merge is going to be coming up after this round. So this is going to be a very important round for the game.
Okay. And the tribes are evenly split 6-6. A bunch of pointless bullshit happens. Pointless. But finally, the Eggy tribe wins immunity, sending LowRes back with no idol in his pocket.
Not good.
The whale leaves the Eggy alliance. Eggy, what happened? I thought that was your new number 3.
Well, I'm going to guess that, you know, we just won this reward, which I didn't quite grasp what it was that we won there because I wasn't paying enough attention. But I'm guessing it was food related, and we probably had to divvy up the food reward between some of us larger men. The whale might not have gotten enough to satisfy, and he might have gotten upset about that. He's like, listen, I got this idol. I don't even need to try and act like I am pleased with that situation. I'm just going to tell you all, middle finger to your face, I'm waddling in the opposite direction.
He got on his little McDonald's or Walmart scooter, hover scooter, and he started slowly going away in the sand, but it kind of got stuck. He ate too much of the reward food, so you guys kicked him out of the alliance. It's fine.
Solar-powered rascal scooter with tank treads to move through the sand. Yes. That's what our reward needs to be.
Jeremy has found an idol, okay? And Varner and LowRes continue their bonding. Could I smell a final two here? You know, the purple men, he saved them with an idol for no reason. LowRes, is this your final two?
I would have to assume at this point, Jeff Varner and I do have a final two. You know, he's such an ostracized player of the game for what he had done in the past. I would have to assume if I took him to the end, then he's not getting any votes. But I kind of feel like things are going to be a little tricky at this tribal council, especially for me now that I'm vulnerable without an idol. Jeremy, he's such an erratic, chaotic player. I could imagine him just playing the idol on somebody like myself, but effectively, and maybe knocking me or Jeff out of the game. We'll see what happens.
Yeah, you did kind of expose yourself as being loyal to Jeff, so they might want to split you guys up this time.
Absolutely.
It looks like Jeremy uses the idol on himself. He's not risking it. He's going to merge no matter what. First vote is for Florian.
Uh-oh.
LowRes. Uh-oh. Ooh, it looks like Jeremy might have wasted his idol. Florian, LowRes. Second vote for LowRes. Second vote for Florian. We're tied 2-2. Florian. And Florian, by a vote of 4-2, Florian has been voted out of the tribe.
Thank God.
Eggy,
that would have been just as dumb.
Are you sad, Eggy, that you won't get to hang out with Florian in the game?
Well, I feel like me and him, we didn't get enough time to talk, to really hash it out, really get to share our experiences that we've been feeling on the island, maybe come to some common ground, but it is what it is. Florian's getting deported back to Ukraine, but... He's our strongest soldier. He's going to be where he needs to be. He's going to help a lot of people out.
Yeah, probably for the best if he's not on the jury, which I don't believe he is. So he can't be arguing against Eggy.
I think Florian is the prototypical pre-merge, last pre-merge boot where you're getting rid of a fairly decent-sized character who could be a threat in the late game if they're not taken care of. And yeah, I think he would have been a bitter juror anyhow, so...
Definitely against Eggy. I mean, he's been holding that grudge for no reason for a fucking year.
Now, my prediction is so far looking correct. Even if Rich Alvarez did not wind up the first boot, your tribe got decimated early on.
Yeah.
And I think the Whale and Rich are looking like they could be end game players. They've had like a good character arc to this point.
Well, we are now merged with the Luke Did Nothing Wrong tribe. Featuring the remaining players of Eggy, Incel Coworker, Jeff Varner, Jeffrey Marsh, Jeremy Fragrance, LowRes Wonder Bread, Puff Saunders, Rich Alvarez, The Whale, Tyrone Jackson, and Vegas Matt. One of these will be our champion.
And I do want to say, with the name of this tribe, shout out to Luke. He did just follow me on social media recently.
Hell so yeah.
That's nice.
What's up. He did a great interview with LowRes and Hans over on the B-Bang podcast, and he said some very spooky shit about how they treated him behind the scenes of Big Brother, and they like intimidated him with a Zoom call full of black people or something crazy. It sounded pretty awesome.
Yeah, I should have put that out around Halloween instead of Thanksgiving. It really was a terrifying ordeal they put him through.
Very, very spooky from the sounds of it. But we have a bunch of random alliances. It doesn't really matter until we see the vote. Incel coworker wins individual immunity. Will he go on a 10-win streak to make it to the end?
That's really impressive. He must have dug deep there to pull this out.
Landed like slats on a podium over the water, moving up with harder bounces. So he did that for 30 minutes. You know what? Since I recently talked to him and he was complaining about how difficult it was to stand, he had some kind of like thoughts. Shots in his knees or something. So he said it was very painful for him to stand. So for him to do this, it really shows he's got that survivor mentality.
Yeah, he really dug deep. Okay. The new idol has been, it's hidden. Nobody has found it yet. Okay. The whale still has his idol. Marsh has a major meltdown. Now, is this an Audrey BB17 scenario? Is the only trans person in the game having some sort of emotional breakdown here?
I think so. A lot of the problems stem from not looking feminine enough. You can see the 5 o'clock shadow, and that's a pregame photo. I would have to imagine at this point there's a full-on Rupert Bonham-style beard coming out of Jeffrey's face. So Jeffrey, I think, probably wants to leave the game at this point and get a razor.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Varner is impressing the tribe. Cool. And incel co-worker has left the Eggy and Vegas Matt alliance. Eggy, it's just you and Matt left. That's not good.
He's getting this immunity. He's changing up on us.
Yeah, he's getting cocky. Perhaps too cocky, but we'll find out. Because it's time to vote. And the whale uses the Simian tribe hidden immunity idol on Rich Alvarez. These fucking original Simian tribe people are staying true, protecting each other. It's insane. And it paid off because Rich is the first vote, does not count. Rich does not count. Rich does not count. How did the whale know and why would he save Rich? That's my question. Rich does not count. Rich does not count. Puff. We have one vote for Puff, 5 votes left. Puff.
Uh-oh.
Marsh.
Oh.
Marsh. Okay, we're all tied up. Puff. And it's a tied vote. After 5 Rich votes were canceled by the whale's idol, the remaining 6 votes were split between Jeremy Marsh and Puffers. So let's vote again. Marsh, Puff. Marsh, Puff. Puff, Marsh, Marsh, and it's Marsh.
Yeah. All right. I think he wanted to go. I think he, you know, they were doing him, they were euthanizing him, essentially.
And he will be the first member of the, or he or she, it's hard to tell, will be the first member.
They're the first member.
Okay, thank you. I honestly do not know, but I'm glad I don't have to worry about it anymore because they are gone. Eggy, how do you feel about how that vote went? Were you hoping that Rich Alvarez would be leaving?
Well, frankly, I think for the only reason being that Marsh just had this meltdown, obviously it's a factor that we probably don't need. It's too volatile. So I think Marsh being voted out was probably the best thing. We need calm, level-headed people in these challenges. We don't need this wild card business. We don't know what's going on. Might as well just go for the straight shot, no pun intended.
It's for tribe harmony, you could say. Eggy finds the new Luke did nothing wrong tribe super idol. This is not the normal idol. This is the fucking Tony Vlachos won the game because he found this idol, Eggy. The Tyler Perry idol. He did introduce this to Jeff, and Jeff put it in the game. Pretty much, Eggy, if you get voted out, you can use this idol to stay in the game. It has never been done on the show before because Tony found it and then just never got voted out. So you might be making history today.
That's what I'm trying to do. I feel like a very historical kind of guy. So I think let's take it all the way. Confident.
Have they ever explained this, LowRes? If he gets voted out and he uses this idol, do they just vote again? Or do they take his one vote?
Well, it would play out like the regular hidden immunity idol. They've done a version of it before Tony, too. It wasn't really Tyler Perry's invention. They just let him believe it was his invention. Oh. So he'd go to the reunion.
Was that at Cook Dietz, Islands?
Yes, Cook Islands. Yule had this idol, and Terry Dietz had it on Exile Island. It has never been played, but yes, it would essentially play out like a regular idol, where whoever had the second most votes is then bounced out of the game. That's how we can anticipate it'll go.
Now, did Terry get pulled from the game for something? Why did he not get to use it? What happened?
Terry made the final 3, so he just won every single challenge. Up until then, they didn't vote for him at final 4 because they knew he had it. And then Terry did get pulled from the game on his second go-around due to his kid having congestive heart failure.
Yeah, I remembered that. It's probably been 2 decades or whatever since I saw his original season, so I could not remember that idol being there, but Eggy found it. So let's see what's going on. Will everybody regret leaving Eggy's alliance now that he has this great power? and more reward shenanigans. Gonna get a
Outback
meal.
Outback Steakhouse.
Yeah.
Wow.
What would you order at Outback Steakhouse on day 28 of Survivor, Eggy?
You know, well, I'm more of a Texas Roadhouse kind of guy, so I'm not really sure, but I'd probably have to go for the Bloomin' Onion. Just eat the whole thing. It's like 1,200 calories, and that's even before the oil sauce or whatever they have next to it. So
yeah, if you ate an entire Bloomin' Onion by yourself after not eating for like 3 weeks, you might be shitting your brains out, Iggy. It might be over for you. You're going to get medevaced.
That's just another, victory
another challenge.
Tactic. You got to just stink it up, you know, just biological warfare, courtesy of an entire Bloomin' Onion, all that grease.
Jeremy's going to lose his shit if he smells you, so hopefully he doesn't get too close. LowRes wins immunity.
All right.
Good job. Keep on your toes. You did it, LowRes.
I think I needed this one, too. There's a lot of alliances going around, and I'm not part of a single one of them.
But that might be a good place to be, is everybody's going for all these big alliance targets, and you can just scoot by to the end.
We'll see.
And drag a Varner with you. Eggy still has an idol. Jeremy and Vegas Matt have a small fight. The Whale and Tyrone bond slightly. Any ideas on this bonding, Eggy?
Well, I think that Tyrone was probably speaking his mind, speaking truth to power, and the Whale is too obese to walk away officially. So he probably sat around, and he was just kind of like, okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, he didn't really consent to the bonding, but he was too fat to leave. And Vegas Matt is injured but gets to stay in the game, so good for him.
One thing about Tyrone and consent, you know, he's very aware of it, so I don't think he would submit anything to anything, not consensually.
Yeah, I think a jury of his peers has proven beyond a reasonable doubt that he respects consent. So we got Eggy with an idol, LowRes has the immunity necklace, and nobody plays any idol because you can't, because you got to use the idol after the vote anyway. Vote number one is for the Whale. Now we have Puff. Incel co-worker. Three different people getting votes early on. The Whale gets his second vote. Puff gets a second vote. Incel co-worker gets a second vote. That's a three-way tie. The Whale. Puff. Incel co-worker. Three-way tie with one vote left. This vote decides it. And incel co-worker. With a fuck, do they call this plurality vote? Fucking four votes out of 10. He's getting his ass voted out.
He came on too strong with that immunity win just the last round. They got threatened by him.
Is that it? Because if maybe he got second place against you in this immunity challenge and they realize he's about to go on a streak. You know, he's the peak of human perfection. He's 500-pound man. We got to get his ass out right now. And they did.
Yep. He was ready to go on a tear.
Eggy, this is one of your longest friends, you know, in life. How do you feel about seeing him lose on Survivor?
Well, it's just like he would say at work. I'm sure he's just happy to go back so he could sit down and eat some more. You know, he went through that rigorous physical conduct, proves that he's got what it takes. But, you know, we can't all be winners. So it's time to go back and just stare at a Netflix screen and think about what Asian wives could have been. It is what it is.
Should they let him go back on the beach, like not as a player anymore, but just because he wants to talk to people? He can just hang out?
I think he would like that very much. Yeah. I think it would be cruel to not allow it, but it is what it is.
I'm sure him and the they-them in Ponderosa will have a lot of fun waiting for the third jury member. Okay, let's see who's leaving next. Episode 9, with 9 people remaining, and not much has changed. Not much has changed. And somebody goes on a spa. I guess Eggy, Varner, and the Whale go on a spa. Okay. Tyrone wins immunity. You know, every time now, somebody different has won individual immunity. Does that mean, LowRes, you are fucked? Are they coming for you since you won last time?
I think I'm done here. This is going to be my swan song of an episode. It's just a gut vibe. There's a lot of alliances. I want immunity. Tyrone is the only other outsider that I can think of anyway. I think my time has reached its breaking point.
But you're still good with Varner. Varner just went on a spa date with Eggy and the Whale or something. Maybe he could talk, you know.
I don't think that's going to make a difference.
He's not going to talk them into keeping you?
I think I might get a pity vote, a sympathy vote, but whoa, maybe he'll return the favor now.
Yeah,
because
it looks like Varner has just found a hidden immunity idol, not a super god idol like Eggy has, just a normal idol. So maybe he will use it to save LowRes, but Varner has a major meltdown. The pressure of the idol is too much. He knows he should save his friend LowRes, but he needs to be, you know, independent and selfish in this game. I would have a major meltdown as well.
Delicate situation to be playing here, so he's got to make a choice.
There is, God, what was his famous line? Like, there is, what did he say about Zeke? There's a level of deception here or something. I'm trying to find a way to tie that line into this situation, but the words are leaving my brain. So just pretend I said something that made fun of him. Tyrone is completely worn out but not giving up, and the whale is injured but gets treated. Good to know.
Yeah, I think that was my last hope, that he might get medically evacuated and save me.
But that was my last hope with Rich Alvarez, and look, he's still fucking right there. He's making top eight.
Rich is going to be in the end game. He's the total villain of the season, but he is very low key at the moment, which means he's going to have a second wind late in the game, I think.
Okay, let's get to this vote. Nobody plays an idol. Puff, he's getting votes again. One vote Puff. One vote LowRes. Uh-oh. Varner did not come through. LowRes.
Oh.
Puff, it's tied 2-2. Puff.
Uh-oh.
Four votes for Puff. Third vote for LowRes. Uh-oh. It's 4-4. LowRes and Puff, one vote left. Uh-oh. And the third juror is... Puff! Puff!
Oh. Yeah! Oh my god.
LowRes, you made it!
I pulled it out. I can't believe it. Wow.
Wow. Yeah, by one vote, you stay in the game. I mean, you're...
Let's see who turned against me here.
Yeah, let's take a look at these votes. Okay, Eggy voted out LowRes.
Eggy.
Varner had your side. Thank God for Varner. Puff, of course, votes for LowRes. Rich Alvarez is on your side.
Oh,
you might have a final three with him and Varner. That'd be pretty iconic. And Tyrone is going for LowRes. Vegas Matt goes for LowRes.
Okay. So it looks like your tribe and the original LowRes tribe glued together on this one to protect me, to keep me in the game.
Yeah, and that's a good strategy, too. If Whale and Rich can team up with the LowRes people to get out the Eggy people, I mean, why not?
Yeah.
You know, take advantage of the numbers.
Very cutthroat, Eggy. I can't believe you.
Down to an iconic final eight with Eggy and LowRes still hanging in there, plus actual Survivor players and some of our YouTube heroes and legends. Let's keep going. Okay, not much has changed. And group one, Varner, LowRes, Tyrone, and Vegas Matt won a barbecue lunch. Congratulations.
Group one is actually me, Jeremy, and Whale. And yeah.
Well, I can't read that fast, but I can say that Rich Alvarez has won immunity.
That's right. I'm happy to be in a alliance with him in Vegas, Matt. I think he's going to look out for us.
Okay. Varner, meanwhile, is impressing the tribe.
Kind of an uneventful episode, but we'll see what happens at Tribal.
Okay. It's time to vote. Nobody plays an idol. Vote one goes for Tyrone. He did win the immunity last time, so it's a bit of a streak. They tried to get LowRes for winning, but they were off by one. Vote number two is for Tyrone. Ooh, LowRes is getting votes again. And the whale gets a vote. They're really just firing everywhere. LowRes gets a second vote, tying him with Tyrone. The whale gets a second vote, so it's 2-2-2 tie with two votes left. LowRes gets a third vote.
Oh, boy.
And it's a tie between LowRes and the whale with three votes each. Okay.
Maybe, I think it's my turn.
Maybe they'll get rocked out. Revote LowRes, the whale, the whale, LowRes, the whale, and the whale by 4-2. LowRes holds on again. God.
Jesus.
Oh, my God.
By the skin of my teeth, both times. I cannot believe it. I am becoming the underdog of the game. I'm the Mike Holloway now of this season.
Yeah, can you think of a Survivor contestant who, like, got the minority of votes multiple tribals in a row? Like, people just keep trying to get him, and he survives.
Philip Shepherd, maybe, the specialist, Jonathan, all these obnoxious characters. I must be rubbing people the wrong way.
No, you're in good company. Yeah, Philip Shepherd, he works for the CIA. They don't just let anybody in there.
That's true. That's very true.
Okay. Here's some votes. Okay. Yeah. Rich Alvarez has it out for you, LowRes, after he heard what you said about his movie.
Yeah, he's a slime ball. He was working with me the last round. This round, he's against me. I mean, you can't trust this guy. You can't pin him down.
All right, final seven. Eggy, do you have any thoughts on this final seven?
Well, I mean, I like the whale, but he was cutting into my food. We just won this reward, barbecue lunch. Really, if he hadn't been there, I would have been able to eat more. But I think that me, Rich, and Vegas Matt, our bond is so strong. We all do it for the tubes. We all love to gamble and achieve, very different goals from what the mainstream might want you to go for. They say, oh, you can't be a grown man drinking on weird live stream websites, dressing up in Mario costumes, and gambling $100,000 a day. But we understand it's called being a Sigma, and it got perpetrated and misconstrued by these memes, but we're living that real Sigma life, and I think we might just all, if we get to final three, we might all just drink the Kool-Aid and commit mass unalive on the island to really prove a point to society.
Well, I do.
I think it's a beautiful thing.
I am a fan of your little trio or whatever your alliance is, but I feel like LowRes and Varner, that might be the heart and soul of this season. Like it's thrown back to Borneo, the original season where the eventual winner is this gay guy. He's hooking up with this old man, and you'd think that they wouldn't be friends in real life because they're so different. But you know, they foster and grow this relationship, and I feel like the same thing has happened this season.
Does that make me the gay guy or the old man in this situation?
I mean, I guess Jeff is both. You're kind of just making, you're like neither one of them, but.
There's an interesting situation here where there's three Eggy players, three LowRes players, and Rich Alvarez in the middle. So I could see this going down into tribal lines and Rich being a swing vote here.
And he swings back and forth every episode.
It seems like it.
That's a good strategy if you can do it. Eggy, of course, has the greatest advantage, still having the super idol. Varner still has an idol that he did not want to use on LowRes, but you know it paid off because he didn't need to. And let's see who's getting immunity this time. They have the Survivor auction, which was just brought back in the most recent season after not being there for like fucking 10 seasons in a row. And they've ruined it. We haven't really talked about this, LowRes, but I don't like the new auction. Why the fuck did they do it the way they did it?
What's your problem with the new auction?
So they took out advantages because people kept saving their money for them. But then they also said, if you have the most money at the end of the auction, you lose your vote. I think
you only need one of those.
You only need one. Like, if the whole point is to stop people from saving money for advantages, do one or the other. Because then in the auction, it was just whoever had the most money bid all of their money on the next item. Like, it wasn't even an auction. It was whoever has the most money in the next round gets the item.
Yeah, I don't like the fact that they're introducing now 45 seasons in. Now you can lose your vote. Now three people are losing their votes. Half the cast will lose their votes. It seems very contradictory to what this game is supposed to be. So I agree with you. I don't mind it here and there, but I think the abundance of it and it becoming an every round sort of thing is just, it's too much.
Yeah. Well, let's see who wins what in this auction. Tyrone gets popcorn and candy. Cool. Varner wins some quesadillas. Eggy, he wins a choice of two covered items between a steak sandwich and a bowl of rice, and he chooses the bowl of rice. So poor Eggy. I hope he got a steak at Outback. LowRes wins the steak sandwich that Eggy didn't get. Eggy then wins three succulent barbecue ribs and a bottle of beer. And then you also got an advantage, a clue to a hidden immunity idol, which I think is not...
Eggy cleaned house on this. Eggy got some good stuff.
Yeah, and some people didn't get anything, so I don't know what they were waiting for. Because Eggy even got the advantage at the end. So, like, what the fuck were they saving their money for? A tire when they get home?
I think Vegas Matt was saving his money to do some more rock gambling.
Well, Eggy, I don't know what you're going to do with this immunity idol advantage, because I think somebody already has it, but let's continue. And then Eggy wins immunity.
Wow.
Eggy's biggest episode ever. And you still have the Eggy. Other god idol, so you're guaranteed like final five right now, Eggy.
Woo! Hey, you know what?
Eggy's odds of winning are looking real good right about now. He's got his alliance, he's got his immunity, he's got his super idol. I mean, what is standing in this guy's way?
This is the Tony season. He might be the Tony.
Mm.
Okay. Secret advantages. Eggy has whatever the hell. Varner has whatever the hell. Varner gets injured, but is treated and can stay in the game. That's happened probably 20 times this season.
No medevac so far.
Unfortunately. Okay. Eggy is safe. It's time to vote. Vote number one, LowRes. I've been here before. Vote number two, Tyrone. Tyrone. Wow. It was 6-1.
Amazing.
Wow. People have given up on getting you out, LowRes. Everybody.
I guess so.
Went for Tyrone.
It looks like I've reintegrated back into the game at this point. They're kind of like, get rid of LowRes? That was an idea 2 episodes ago. We're past that now. Tyrone's still here.
Own tribe voted him out. Every single person. Yeah. Eggy, how do you defend this? Why would you vote out Tyrone?
Well, I think it was... I was eating that delicious succulent barbecue, and I was drinking that cold bottle of Old English, and I'm like, you know, I think we might have enough African-American representation with, I'm eating this good soul food. It's making me feel like I'm a brother from another, you know what I'm saying? So, if it was versus LowRes, I'm like, he kind of, you know, he ain't giving me, I mean, you know, he ain't got that soul food mentality, so I feel like, you know, he wasn't the first one on my mind. I just felt like, you know, I was cornering my market and I had to clear house.
Yeah, I'll give this to Tyrone. He is responsible for the single greatest podcast we've done this year, if not just ever. So thank you to big man Tyrone for his shenanigans in the courtroom. But this ain't the courtroom, buddy. This is Survivor. And you have to be the whale if you want to make it in the big leagues or whoever the fuck is left. You have to be Rich Alvarez if you want to be successful on this island. So, yeah, Tyrone, it's time to go.
I will say, traditionally, if you look back at Survivor lore, 7th place, always a black guy. So
really?
This fits. This,
okay.
Yes, Jervis, Nick, season 2, you know, it's just tradition.
So, Brant Steele AI is really on the ball. They know exactly what's going on. They could read the pigmentation of his skin in this fucking photo. Okay.
You can't get more proud African with a K than that picture right there, so it's understandable.
We have a beautiful final 6. Varner has an idol. Eggy has a super idol. LowRes is getting votes every single fucking tribal, and that's his face the whole time, but he's still here. there's a good chance of... And this is a final 2. This season has a final 2.
Yep.
So I can't even say there's a good chance that LowRes and Eggy will be in final 3, because, you know, it doesn't even matter at that point. I forgot this is a final 2, so this will be really good.
It's a good classic Black Friday season.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you should have been live streaming this, and it's going to come out way after Black Friday, but that is when we are recording.
Good classic Christmas season.
Mm-hmm. Not much to report on, so let's take a look. And it looks like Eggy, Jeff, and Vegas Matt have won. They get to bring hamburgers and hot dogs to school children.
That's right. Jeff's like, by the way, better not be transgender, boy.
Yeah.
Vegas Matt's like, I just won how much money and gave it to school children? And I'm just like sneaking hamburgers and hot dogs in my pocket.
Yeah. Hopefully you guys get to eat some of the food, because it seems kind of cruel that they would starve you and then make you give food to somebody else.
Yeah, it's not really a win after all.
Eggy, you beast.
Eggy wins immunity, and this is the final 6, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now he's getting... Go
extra
ahead,
hot dogs, those extra hot dogs and hamburgers I was stealing from those children gave me the energy I needed to take it all the way.
Yeah, now you're guaranteed final 4, I believe, if that's how that super idol works. I don't know when the last time you can use it is, though. Is it 5?
5. Okay. It is 5. So Eggy's looking at a trip to the final 4. He's looking real good right now. Mm. I would put my money on Eggy.
Well, he just had a major meltdown, so he might be scaring people off from voting for him in the end. Meanwhile, Rich and Jeremy find something in common, and as we have seen, that usually has a real impact on the vote. That's not good news for LowRes, I don't think.
No, I think I'm getting more votes yet again.
Okay, final 6 showdown. Nobody plays an idol. 1 vote for Rich Alvarez. LowRes, Rich Alvarez. This will decide who has the superior YouTuber movie, Mass State Lottery or Stupid Mario Brothers.
Yep.
Okay. LowRes, it's all tied up. We've been here before. Mario, oh. Rich, and it's a tie vote, 3-3. They're going to revote, and if nobody changes their vote, they have to draw rocks.
That would be beautiful, but I think it's going to be me this time around. I just got a vibe. Rich is too conniving of a player. He's bonded with Jeremy Fragrance, you know? This is not good news. And my ticket has been up for episodes upon episodes, so we'll see.
But if nobody budges, could Eggy get rocked out with a super idol?
That would be amazing, except he won immunity. So
fuck, you're right.
He's untouchable.
You're right.
Untouchable.
Good thinking. Okay, Eggy, so you don't have to stress. Eggy does not have to change his vote. It doesn't fucking matter to him what happens. I don't think anybody's going to change. I think it's going to be a tie again.
Well,
LowRes. LowRes. Mario Rich. And it's LowRes. 3-1.
Well, I knew it. Sixth place, not too shabby, though. Not too shabby.
Let's see, Eggy voted
Jeremy.
You out. Yep. Jeremy switched his vote.
That was a good move for Jeremy Fragrance. He didn't want to draw rocks. He knew he would be at risk here. So
it's that damn lasting impact.
I just want to say I'm glad that Rich and Vegas Matt did not turn their back on the Alliance. I mean, I know they were under a lot of pressure, but we're taking it to another level. Let's go.
Why did Jeff Varner not use his idol to save his only ally?
I think he was thinking, you know what? I have Final Four guaranteed if I just get through this round. I don't blame him. I think it was probably the smarter move here for Jeff.
Yeah, so if Eggy and Jeff are both safe from idols and then somebody's going to win immunity, it might just be down to two people in this final five vote. Okay, last round to use idols. Eggy wins a reward and he shares the pizza with Vegas Matt.
Challenge beast.
Why did you choose Matt to share your food with over the other players, Eggy?
Well, I think we're probably talking about our love of the games of chance, and maybe we did like a rock, paper, scissors, and if Vegas Matt beat me, then he was the only person I was going to share it with. Otherwise, if I beat him, I would have shared it with more people. Okay. But Vegas Matt, he's a professional, so he was obviously booking an easy win, and then me and him split it half and half.
Well, let's see if that pizza fueled him to win immunity, and it did not. Eggy wins another immunity. Did not even need his super idol. Completely useless because he went on a fucking win streak.
So Eggy is more of a Terry Dietz here in this situation where he has the insurance policy of that super idol, but he cannot help himself from winning every single challenge. This is dangerous for Eggy as he approaches Final Four and has vulnerability exposed.
Yeah, for the first time in the game, pretty much, he'll be vulnerable. And I think they're going to take that opportunity because he's such a big target now.
Absolutely.
Eggy, I mean, how do you feel about this? I mean, you're going on a big win streak. You're guaranteeing your spot towards the end of the game. Do you think you're making too big of a target on your back?
Well, I think that the nature of the game, there's no hiding. There's no hiding off in the corner and sneaking to the side to draw attention on somebody else unless they're having that major meltdown. But unfortunately, Marsh is out of the game already. It's just how it's got to be. And I'll just hope that my alliance that I've had for many... there we go. See Rich and Vegas Matt. See, they've disagreed each other right there. Both of them originally from... Or no, I guess they weren't originally from my team because Rich wasn't. But after the dissolve, what was that, like episode 3... They've been rocking with me for a long time. They both got a lot of love for me, and now they're hating on each other. I think that bond that I share with those two is going to be the most impactful at this stage of the game.
Will Eggy give his idol to somebody?
Can you give the super idol away?
I think you can, or I think you can even maybe play it on somebody else after the vote. So he could protect somebody. I think so.
Huh. Well, I don't know if he... Unless it's Vegas Matt himself, I don't know if Eggy's going to care to save Rich. Because I'm guessing it's going to be between these two. If they had a disagreement with a lasting impact, they're probably voting for each other. But let's see. Okay. Eggy has his necklace. Varner stands up and plays his idol for himself. Any votes for Varner will not count. First vote, Varner does not count. It must have been a very secret idol. Jeremy. Rich... Rich.
Uh-oh.
Jeremy. So it's a tie. 2 votes Jeremy, 2 votes Rich, and a 1 canceled Varner vote. I think Rich is going to be leaving this time.
I think it's Jeremy.
Well, you might be right. Jeremy gets one. Rich gets one. 1 vote left. And Jeremy, god damn it. I mean, I don't even care about this guy, but the closer Rich gets to the end, the more concerned I have to be.
It would be a very twisted reversal here if Rich is indeed the winner of the season after being predicted as the first boot. But I can see it. I kind of get the vibe maybe Rich is the final two loser. I don't know. He's so unlikable.
Well, we do have representation from all three starting tribes with Eggy, Jeff Varner, and Rich Alvarez, plus Vegas Matt's there too. So really, any of us could still get the spiritual win that one of our contestants won, Eggy. And I guess you're still there to coach Vegas Matt. If Eggy gets eliminated in fourth, then it's just one of our little people each. Let's see what's going on. Eggy wins the final for immunity.
Oh, boy.
Eggy.
Varner's time
this
is up.
This coach is going all the way, baby. I can't help it. You know, I'm so pumped up off of that Mario Kino, that high-intensity gambling dopamine. I'm just really so focused, eating delicious soul food and pizza and everything else.
Yeah, you've been eating better than you eat at home. And if this was a normal season, you would have just guaranteed the finals to go talk to the jury. But, of course, the twist was that it's a final two. So, Eggy, you still might get fucked. Like, you have to win yet another immunity or you're getting fucked.
See.
Eggy's impressing the team, and he works so hard that he gets tired. Okay. It's time to vote.
This is a slam dunk vote for Varner. They have an alliance, Eggy, Rich, and Vegas Matt. I think it would probably be smart to get rid of Rich here if you're Eggy, but I can't see it happening.
Well, we have 1 vote Varner, 1 vote Rich, Varner, and it's exactly as LowRes just described. Varner, I don't know, if Varner would have played his idol to save you, that would have been another person to vote on his side here.
We're looking at a different final three entirely. The LowRes side is then final three. You have Jeremy, Varner, and myself as the top three. Eggy's probably going out at 4.
Well, Eggy keeps getting immunity. He's never leaving.
That's a good point, too. Yeah. Eggy's streak cannot be contended with.
But Varner, if he wasn't selfish and saved his stupid idol for when he didn't even need it, it could have been a whole different game.
It's all right. LowRes goes down as America's sweetheart. Colleen, Amber, 6th place, always America's sweetheart.
We have our final three of Eggy, Rich Alvarez, and Vegas Matt. I kind of want Rich to win just because he was one of my players, but also I really don't want Rich to win. So we'll see.
Well, he's on the outs here.
Jesus! Eggy wins the most important immunity for the final two, which means he gets to choose who goes to the final two with him. He's in the woo position. Hopefully he doesn't make the same mistake. But Eggy, you just won fucking like 5 or 6 immunities in a row. Like, this isn't even Survivor anymore. This is just who can stop Eggy.
I mean, what can I say? I just, I got a winner's mentality. You see me eating that Play-Doh, you know? Whatever it takes, we got to go all the way. I don't know anything else. I either win or die. That's the only way I know.
Well, who do you think you're going to take to the final two with you? Vegas Matt over Rich Alvarez, hopefully?
But Matt, he's so conniving. I mean, that's a bad word to use. He's very, he's so intellectual. He's a real...
But he's already a millionaire. Maybe they don't want to give him the money.
I feel like... I don't know. I feel like I want Rich to go to the final two. I feel like that's going to be better for me personally. If I'm really self-inserting,
Two of my role models in life in the final two would be fitting. You and Rich. Okay, it's time to vote.
Here we go.
Eggy has voted out Rich Alvarez. Thank God, I guess.
Long overdue.
Rich Alvarez, third place finisher. He's in the cast position.
It makes total sense in retrospect that he would be in the cast position here. I think Eggy is winning this in a 7-2 vote. Vegas Matt, he's been kind of under the radar most of the season. He's been a good, loyal companion for the Eggy Alliance. Rich, he was too much of a game player. 3rd place, destiny.
Yeah, Eggy had complete control of the merge portion of the game just because he won all the immunities, but then every vote pretty much went his way. I mean, I don't know if he ever voted for the wrong person. I might be wrong on that, but...
He voted for me one time I stayed in, so that was the one exception, probably.
He was right to try to get you out, though, because you would have been a big threat against Vegas Matt here. But we have the jury of nine. Eggy and Vegas Matt, again, face off with these people. Ask some funny questions.
Is there a bitter jury here, do you think, against Eggy running the show the entire season?
No, I think bitter juries, you have to be bad at the social game as well, perhaps, unless you're like a Dan Giesling who they just were out to get from the get-go for being a vet. I think Eggy's affable enough that his bonds will make people enjoy voting for him over Vegas Matt. So despite his... complete domination of the competitions, I think Eggy can still win. Okay, first vote goes to Eggy. Second vote goes to Vegas Matt. Eggy. Vegas Matt, it's 3-2 in favor of Eggy. You need 5 to win. Eggy gets his fourth vote. Vegas Matt gets a third vote. And our winner by 6-3 is Eggy.
All right. Congratulations, Eggy. Oh, my God. $1 million.
What a game.
Pocket, Eggy.
You know, I've kind of
been a deserving winner.
I've been in the mood to win $1 million lately. So. Vegas Matt, he's got that. He's got so much invested in these casinos. He's guaranteed to win $1 million here pretty soon. So I needed somebody like myself who just doesn't have those kind of connections. Somebody really got it out the mud and out the beach sand to take home a victory.
Well, let's see the breakdown. Incel co-worker stayed loyal, voted for Eggy. Varner votes for Eggy. Marsh votes for Eggy. Jeremy votes for Eggy. LowRes, he's a little bitter. He doesn't like that Eggy won all those challenges. He votes for Vegas Matt. Puff votes for Eggy. Rich votes for Eggy. Rich respected you. You voted him out final three. He said, fuck it, you get my vote anyway. So that's a sign of good social game. And the Whale and Tyrone both voted for Vegas Matt. Tyrone, you might have voted in his favor, but he did not vote in your favor, Eggy.
Well, it is, he's got those thousands of years of oppression from the YT man. It is what it is.
Do we have any predictions on America's favorite player?
God, it's probably going to be...
Rich Alvarez?
I feel like... No,
Puff.
I think it might be Tyrone or the Whale.
Okay. I'm going to put my money on Rich and Puff. What about you, Eggy?
For the...
America's favorite.
I'm going to say for representation purposes, I think the Whale and Tyrone are... the Whale and Tyrone, I think, are going to be the fan favorites.
Let's find out. Ben Shapiro!
Wow, out of nowhere.
He was pre-merge, if I recall. So
He was the fourth boot. He was out in episode 3, I think. So he must have mobilized his subscribers, and this felt like a stacked deck vote.
His close friends who also might be very influential in American voting.
Oh, you think that Ben and his people might, manipulate elections and run the media? And that's how... Okay, now I see how that could... Okay, because he's conservative.
Fan favorite, yes, exactly. Of course, the Republicans.
Right.
But it's about who the most eyes and ears you're reaching to the people, of course, is what determines the fan favorite. So anyway.
And there we have our game. Me and Hans, rightfully, down at the bottom with only Use Me Blade. You know what? Another successful Survivor Simulator. LowRes, what did you think?
I thought this was a very well-rounded, great season of Survivor here, where you do wind up with a great cast full of memorable characters lining out the endgame and a very deserving winner here in Eggy. I do think maybe we need a Rob versus Russell season with you and Hans, though, for the very unfortunate placement that you guys wound up getting here.
Well, I put myself in these every time, and I think I've been free jury probably every single time we've done it. So the simulator just doesn't like me for some reason. Eggy, what's the farthest you've made it before? Have you made it, like, towards the end?
I don't feel like I've ever made it very far. No, what was that one? It was like, I can't remember if it was me or if it was my tribe, but I feel like wasn't it like a Final Four that had Biggs in it, and can't remember who it was even, but I remember that one. That might have been, I can't remember how many of these I've even done.
Yeah, me neither.
The only other one I've done. I've done like two of them, but there was one I believe, and it's a little fuzzy, but I think there was one where it was like Biggs and me were like the Final Four or something, and but I might have been somebody out of my tribe, not actually me, but I can't recall 100%.
Well, either way, you won this time. Nobody can ever take that away from you. You're up there with my cat Isabel as a winner of Simian Jimmy Survivor Simulator. LowRes, you have anything you want to plug?
Check out Babang. Mumpke's favorite podcast.
That's
featuring
right.
His favorite podcast host, 18th place finisher Hans. check that out this week. We just had an episode drop I don't know when this is coming out, but we did a Thanksgiving episode. I'm sure there's a new episode out already for this stream. And also check out Movies, a podcast about the act of cinema.
And Eggy, I know you found the password to your old YouTube channel. Is that worth plugging, or should we just go straight to Rumble?
Yeah, rumble.com/c/EggyWhite. I think that YouTube account is marinated or stewed enough now that I could actually put some of my information into it tonight. We're going to find out. But no, this YouTube, man, I guess I got to say this is crazy now. And people have told me about this, but I didn't realize it because it's based on... It's not based on how old your account is, which is what I had thought incorrectly. It's based on when you verified your account previously. So now you can't just do a phone number anymore. That's what it used to be. You could just put a phone number in. And they still you use the same phone number twice a year. So you could actually have two accounts per year. And that's fine, apparently. But anyway, you have to send YouTube a copy of your driver's license.
What?
Whoa.
To make community posts, to post links on your channel, to pin a comment, to upload videos longer than... No, actually, never mind. Phone number, you can do videos longer than 15 minutes. I think it's maybe custom thumbnails you need to send your ID in for.
Wow.
Or,
I've never heard of that.
Yeah, this is what... Or it's you send them a video of your face for facial biometric recognition. So they like scan your face into YouTube's database or something. If you don't do those, you have to upload short videos on your channel for 2 months, and then you can apply after 2 months of uploading to be able to do those other things.
You can apply.
Yeah.
That's
what
the fuck are they thinking?
I don't know. It's shocking, really. I mean, and that's the thing of it is like, yeah, I'm on YouTube now still, but it's just so undesirable compared to the alternatives. I know it's still like what everybody uses. It still comes on all your phones and everything. It's like the go-to, but it's just so much less good than the competing websites now that it's very difficult to desire using it, honestly. And like, yeah, that's just how I feel. So
I can't blame you. I mean, when your shit gets deleted, it fucking rocks your world for a little bit. And you've been through it way more times than I have. So fuck that, man.
Yeah,
fuck YouTube.
I mean, if they still had dislikes, if they still allowed ad blockers, if they weren't charging $15 a month for ad-free videos.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, this whole thing of biometric face scan, sending your driver's license just to be able to make a community post. It used to be 1,000 subscribers, I believe, is the requirement before, but now they really want to know everything about you. It's pretty soon it's probably going to be social security number,
yeah,
birth certificate. Yeah. I mean, driver's license is already pretty close, but yeah.
To make a fucking YouTube channel? That is insane.
Yeah, I mean, I went to go, because I know I couldn't do a community post. I did a little video just for notification sake of like, oh yeah, I'm going to be live on Rumble. And I was going to pin, because I can't post a link without having my driver's license submitted. So I was like, all right, well, I'm just doing like rumble.com/. You know, I'm typing the words out, so I was going to pin it. And when I go to pin the comment, then it says... you can pin comments. All you got to do is just submit your driver's license for verification. I'll do it right now. Just look at it again. Get advanced features with a quick one-time verification to fight spam.
Well, do you? So why don't you just do it? You think that they'll recognize Eggman Rodriguez from his other account?
Well, I'm not super keen to give YouTube a copy of my driver's license.
But I think they, I mean, honestly, they probably already have everything on all of us, right? Like, what are they going to do with your driver's license? Oh, now they know your address while you're fucking like on their website using your IP.
Yeah. Well, and also it says here, your ID will be deleted within a few months after you have sufficiently uploaded, or if you don't upload, it will be deleted after 2 years.
Yeah, so, I mean, as long as they don't recognize you, yeah. But then again, fuck YouTube, just stay on Rumble. You know, we don't need to appease them.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, the YouTube account's been uploading for 15 years, so really they should, but it is what it is. I have it. It's there to have. That's basically where I'm at. I'm not trying to make some huge channel and make it a huge thing, but
right.
If I can find something I'm interested in, I might maybe turn it into a gaming channel for a little bit, because I've been really on my gamer stuff lately, so maybe that. But otherwise, nice. Rumble has been sufficient. Yeah, pretty much.
LowRes, when should I come on to B-Bang?
How about this upcoming week? Basically, I'm in Massachusetts up until the 30th, so anytime after the 30th, I think would be an ideal time to record Ba-Bang, and we'll have you on for your return, even though you didn't know you were on the first time.
Well, it'll be nice to be able to talk to Hans about not movies, you know? I can really open up his brain and pry in and get all the juicy information I want.
Well, what are you looking for? What are you hoping to learn?
I need to have a full psychological evaluation of Hans. Like, I really want to get in there with my therapist tools and really see the true man behind the mask.
Yeah, you should put out like a documentary, like how it'll be like, oh, inside the mind of a serial killer. And it's like interrogation room footage of a mass shooter or something. I think that would be very good and helpful for Hans to gain even more of a base.
Yeah,
he's such a lovely man.
I think he would like it if thousands of strangers were watching a psychological profile about him. So, yeah, we'll get to work on that.
Yes,
but I think that's about it for this epic Survivor Brant Steel Simulator. Once again, congrats to Eggy, but I've been Simian Jimmy.
I have been Eggy Rodriguez, the true victor of the island. Thank you.
And I've been LowRes Wonderbread. It's been a pleasure surviving so many tribal councils, only to come up short to the one and only Eggman here.